Many designers either won't know everything in today's video, or they just won't understand how useful they really are. The first one is a handy function that is far superior to the Gaussian blur effect, and you'll soon see why. So when you have your shape or your object, come up to Stylize, and then select the Feather option. You'll notice this box up here where you can control the feather radius, which can maybe feather the blur edge of your object, or you can just totally blend a shape into the background. But why is this better than the Gaussian blur? Well, let's try and create a Gaussian blur with a new circle. You can see the render is pretty terrible. And yes, we can often change the document raster effect settings, which sometimes does help, but this feather option is just so clean and so reliable. It's great for aspects on designs such as the glow seen on this moon. The feather tool is awesome for vector art, but let's move on to the next part of today's tutorial. Here is a really large and complicated design that I'm currently working on. More about that soon. This next tool really helps with your navigation within a workflow, and is something I only recently started using myself. And yes, I know the text down here is set to differing sizes. A lot of this design is actually unfinished, just a heads up. Anyway, this tool in question is found under the window drop-down menu and then found here, Navigator. You get this pretty cool little window that opens up and essentially shows you your entire document and beyond. The red outline box here shows the section your screen can currently see and view, and you can just click any part of your document to instantly transport to that section. Or you can click and drag around your Navigator window and scroll around your document in real time. You're also able to set the magnification of the zoom while working in this window. But yeah, it's so helpful to have this function off to the side, ready to make use of at any time. This design is going to be a huge, in-depth PDF guide to logo designing. It's going to take whoever uses it along the design process step by step, with some tips and some hints along the way. More about that later this month. There is a tool in Illustrator that most people never use or even know about. So we have two shapes here, and a lot of designers, including myself, love to use the Pathfinder tool, which is of course completely fine. However, there is a little nifty tool that is found here. If we select a shape, and we can use this kind of cookie cutter tool to cut the shape below. Divide objects below is great for making new shapes, possibly for logo designing or other geometric type designs. It's just another function that's great to know about when you're using Adobe Illustrator. Next up, something to do with typography. So I have here two semicircles in Illustrator with two lots of text, the font being of course Basement Grotesque. So to flip this text below so it's actually legible, we can zoom in here and just flip it like so, which can be a bit fiddly actually. There is a whole separate panel that some designers aren't even aware of. With your text selected, come into this menu here. And now we can flip the text with just one click. That's pretty cool. But also we have other options to play around with. The first one is just an artistic way to arrange your text with styles. And I rarely ever use this one to be honest, but it's just there if you need it, of course. And then below that is an option that dictates where the text is on the path. So essentially below it, in the center of it, or above it. And then finally, some spacing settings for the characters on your text along a path. So yeah, this is one panel that some people don't know about, but which is actually very, very useful. And here's one I'm sure many of you, if not most of you, do know about, but there will be people watching this video who don't know about it, so I do want to share it because it is so helpful. So I have here a very complicated design. If I go ahead and press Command or Control Y, I enter into line mode. Line mode is so helpful for illustrating, but also maybe more so logo designing. Now you can see exactly where the vector paths are, despite the size of the stroke or whatever effect is applied. Heading into line mode is something I toggle between a lot on my designs. And to exit line mode, you just simply press Command or Control Y once again, so you can keep hopping in and out of it pretty easily throughout your workflow. It's another tool to your arsenal when working in Illustrator. And here again, we have two more circles, but this time with a different tip. I've spoken about this one on the channel before, but that was a long time ago and it is so helpful. If we use the minus front option in the Pathfinder window, I cut the top shape into the shape below. The thing is that we can see in the layers window just here that we have just one shape. If I then go ahead and commit the same process, but this time, if I hold down the Alt key on Windows or the Option key on a Mac, while clicking the Pathfinder function, I now have a genuine compound path. We can come into the layers window and then click only the middle section with the blue icon, and then just manipulate the shape and the size in any which way we want to. This isn't a colored circle, you are literally seeing through the shape onto the background, and I can demonstrate that right here. So there are some nifty tools and probably actually hidden tools to some people. I hope you got some value from this video, but if you do want to see more graphic design content by myself, just click a video on screen. And until next time guys, design your future today. Peace.